मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ विजय, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री फ्रॉम माउंट सीनाई हायर सेकेंडरी स्कूल. इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यूनिट 3 पी ब्लॉक एलिमेंट्स 2. इन दिस लेसन व्हाट आर द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव. फर्स्ट वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज द लर्निंग ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ दिस लेसन. सो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रिपरेशन प्रॉपर्टीज of important compounds of nitrogen, phosphorus, oxygen, sulfur, halogens and hydrogen halides. Is it clear? Halogens are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine. Then hydrogen halides. Is it clear? What is hydrogen halides? HF, HCl, HBr and hydrogen iodide. This is a compound of hydrogen halides. And the occurrence, properties and uses of noble gases. Then explain the chemistry of interhalogen compounds. Interhalogen, the halogen compounds combine to form an interhalogen compound. So we are going to explain the interhalogen compounds and the importance of p block elements, how the way the compounds of nitrogen and nitrogen family compounds are used day to day life. So these are the learning objectives, and we are already learned the general characterization of p block elements for the previous unit. Is it clear? What are the previous unit? We discuss a boron group and carbon group, and in this lesson we are going to discuss about family 15th element, group 15 element, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. These are the special name of this group of compound, pentogen, cyclogen and interhalogen. It's a correction, not the, it's an interhalogen. Then a group 15 nitrogen elements occurrence. We are going to discuss about the occurrence of group 15 elements. About 78% Earth atmosphere dinitrogen gas is occurred. It is also present Earth crust as sodium nitrate and potassium nitrate. The molecular formula sodium nitrate NaNO3 and potassium nitrate KNO3 as an explosive compound. These are the compound as a earth crust. Is it clear? And 11th most abundant in group 15 element as a phosphorus. Phosphorus exists as a phosphate, okay, not in a pure form. So it is exist as a phosphate. So what are the phosphate compound? Fluoroiodide, chloroiodide and hydroxyiodide. These are the compounds of phosphates. Okay, the other elements is a very rare, okay, abundant arsenic, antimony, bismuth and sulfate is not very abundant, is a very rare one. Okay, and physical properties of group 15 elements. Okay, generally in physical properties we discuss about melting point, boiling point, color, appearance, density. Okay, these are the things. And in group 15 elements, nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, bismuth, in a standard temperature exists. Nitrogen exists as a gas, phosphorus exists as a solid, arsenic exists as a solid, and also antimony, bismuth. Okay, and then the isotopes. Nitrogen exists 2 isotope and phosphorus 1. Similarly, arsenic, antimony, bismuth. Is it clear? These are the noble electronic configuration of these compounds. Okay, then the preparation of nitrogen. It is a very very important point. We are going to discuss about group 15 nitrogen group elements. First, how we are going to prepare nitrogen. Okay, the compound of sodium acide thermally decomposed and form sodium and nitrogen molecule. Is it clear? Acide, sodium acide, NaN3, thermal decomposition with, what is the condition? Thermal decomposition 575 Kelvin, it form sodium and nitrogen. It is an industrial preparation by the fractional distillation. Industrial preparation is generally large scale of preparation. Is it clear? Large scale of preparation. We are going to prepare as a large manner. Okay. Next, oxidizing of ammonia using bromine in water. Is it clear? Oxidizing of ammonia using bromine in water form ammonium bromide, the salt, and nitrogen as a product. Okay, so these two methods are used for the preparation of nitrogens. And properties, nitrogen gas is a rather inert and triply bonded species is notable for its less reactivity. Okay, the nitrogen triple bonded species are notable one for it is less reactive in comparison with other isoelectronic triple bonded system. So we are going to compare this triple bonded compound. Okay, nitrogen triple bonded compound is less reactivity. Okay, carbon to carbon triple bond, carbon to oxygen triple bond, then carbon to nitrogen triple bond, the nitrogen to carbon triple bond. Okay, compare these. Nitrogen one is a less reactive. Okay, whereas the group of elements can act as a donor. Okay, donor, because nitrogen have one lone pair electron, so it can act as a donor. Whereas in the other case, dinitrogen cannot donate a lone pair. Is it clear? This nitrogen act as a donor. In this case, this nitrogen act as a donor, but in a dinitrogen cannot donate electron. Okay. However, for example, the complex compound. Okay, metal to nitrogen bond and cobalt carbon monoxide. Is it clear? The CO, to it is a less extreme compound. Okay, carbon monoxide is a less extreme one. Okay. Then next we are going to discuss about the nitrogen react with lithium to form Li3N. Okay, is a condition of dinitrogen reaction with metal, again lithium, at room temperature it form a product. And another method is a evaluated temperature, calcium react with nitrogen with a red hot condition to form a nitrogen compounds. And boron react with nitrogen is a bright red hot to form boron nitrate as a nitrogen compound. In lithium nitrate is a compound of lithium nitrate. Nitrate have one lone pair of electron. Is it clear? But here it is not possible. In boron nitrate, it is possible for a lone pair of electron in nitrogen. And another method where nitrogen directly react with hydrogen to form ammonia in this process is called as a Haber process. Here, iron act as a catalyst. The enthalpy change of this reaction is an exothermic reaction. Enthalpy change of formation of ammonia. F enthalpy, H for enthalpy change of formation of ammonia
It is equal to minus 46.2 kilojoule per mole for the Haber process. And another one, at a room temperature, nitrogen react with oxygen to form as a nitrous oxide. To form as a nitrous oxide with the condition, you just note the condition 3473 Kelvin, 3473 Kelvin as a condition. And uses of nitrogen, the manufacture of ammonia, generally nitrogen used for the manufacture of ammonia, nitric acid, HNO3, calcium cyanamide is a manufacturing process it is used. A liquid nitrogen is used for producing low temperature so that it is required for the cryosurgery with the condition of low temperature it is held. So it is used for the cryosurgery, and also it is a biological preservation compound. Then the preparation of ammonia. Next we are going to discuss about the preparation of ammonia. Ammonia is a compound of nitrogen. So we are going to discuss the preparation of ammonia. First method is hydrolysis of urea. It's a compound of urea going to hydrolysis to form ammonia. And then the laboratory process, the ammonia salt with base, ammonium salt, ammonium NH4 plus ammonium salt with a base to form ammonia. And ammonium chloride a salt, calcium oxide as a base to form calcium chloride, and also the favorable product ammonia is formed. Okay. And third method is metal nitrates. One of the example is magnesium nitrate is going to react with water to form magnesium hydroxide. This excess of product, but our favorable one is ammonia. What is our motto? We are going to prepare ammonia. So it is a main or important product. Is it clear? What is the reaction? A metal nitrates. One of the example is magnesium nitrate is going to react with water to form ammonia as a byproduct, magnesium hydroxide. So in industrially we are going to prepare in large scale. The condition is used iron as a catalyst. We are going to reduce the rate for minimum time we are going to prepare. Okay, we are going to use the condition for reducing the rate of reaction. Okay, to oxides of potassium, oxides of aluminium, these are used at 750 Kelvin at 200 atmosphere pressure. The industrial process is held. Okay, the actual process, hydrogen is required, water, gas and nitrogen form the fractional distillation of liquid. This is another method. Okay, then the properties of ammonia. Okay, ammonia is a pungent, irritating smell, lighter than air compared to air, is very lighter, and it is liquefied the condition of 9 atmospheric pressure, and the liquid boils condition and freezing condition, and liquid ammonia, it is a condition of highly associated through the strong hydrogen bond. Okay, highly association of strong hydrogen bond. Hydrogen bond are classified interhalogen hydrogen bond, intrahalogen hydrogen bond. Inter without the molecule, intra within the molecule hydrogen bond. Is it clear? So it is strong associated is possible. But ammonia extremely soluble water with these condition. At low temperature, two soluble hydrate are possible like this way. These molecules of ammonia linked by hydrogen bonds. Already I discussed what is hydrogen bond. Is it clear? And similar manner, we know the same product of hydrated ammonia in aqueous condition. The next we are going to discuss about the dielectric constant of ammonia. The dielectric constant of ammonia, where ammonia react with water to form salt and base. Okay, plus and minus dielectric property. Okay, it is a general reaction where ammonia ionized form ammonium and amide. Ammonia NH4 plus ammonium and amide. They are dielectric constant. The concentration of ammonium, the concentration of amide, that is equal to 10 power minus 30. Similarly, water ionized to form H3O plus and OH minus is also the dielectric. And their dissociation constant, the concentration of H3O plus, then concentration of OH minus give 10 power minus 14. So generally, in this slide we are discuss the dielectric constant of ammonia. You just compare ammonia and water. Ammonia is 10 power minus 30 and water is 10 power minus 14. Then chemical properties of ammonia. Okay, generally chemical properties, the reaction of ammonia with some other elements or molecules or compounds. Where ammonia decompose, okay, will give the product of nitrogen and hydrogen. Okay, there is a action of heat. Reaction with air, okay, 3 moles of O2 to form N2 and water, and excess of O2 to form NO as a NO as a the compound of nitric acid. And this reaction is a we just consider moles of oxygen, ammonia 3 moles of oxygen, N2 as a product, ammonia 5 moles of oxygen, 4 moles of NO is possible. Oh, so this process is called Ashwall process. When excess of oxygen is supplied, we get NO as a product. It is a process of Ashwall process. Okay. And next, the reducing property of ammonia. Where ammonia react with metal oxides, ammonia reduce the metal oxide to metal. Here lead oxide is example of metal oxide, where lead oxide is reduced as a lead. Okay, is a metal. So ammonia act as a reducing agent, that is a reducing property of ammonia. Ammonia reduce metal oxide like lead oxide to form lead and N2 and water. So nitrogen is produced. Reaction with acid. When ammonia react with acid, ammonia is a weak base, so easily gain hydrogen from acid. Is it clear? This shows the affinity of ammonia. Is it clear? It is greater than that of water. Ammonia NH3 react with some other acid, easily gain one proton from water, from acid. Easily it is protonated, form ammonium salt. Is it clear? So their affinity nature is compared water, it is greater. Is it clear? Reaction with chloride and chlorines. Reaction with chlorine and chlorine. Then excess of ammonia, excess of chlorine. When ammonia react with 3 mole of chlorine to form N2 and 6 mole of HCl. When 6 mole of HCl react with 6 mole of NH3 to form 6 mole of NH4Cl. Then HCl react with ammonia, acid base react to form salt. Generally we know that when acid react with base to form salt as a product. So similarly, acid base react to form as a salt product. When excess of chloride, ammonia react with chlorine to form NCl3. The compound of NCl3 is nothing but the nitrogen trichloride. Nitrogen trichloride is a compound. So it's a very, very important compound. And ammonia react with acid again as base acid to form salt as a product. Okay. And next, the formation of amides and nitrates. These are the metal, sodium, magnesium. These metals are react with ammonia. It's a product of sodium amide and sodium nitrate, magnesium nitrate, where sodium react with ammonia to form sodium. Here the compound of sodium NH2. You just note the point. NH4 is ammonium, NH3 is ammonia, NH2 is amide. What is that? Amide. Okay, amide compound. So it's a sodium amide. Magnesium react with ammonia to form magnesium nitrate. Is it clear? Magnesium nitrates. And reaction with metallic solids. What is a metallic solids? Ammonium react with iron. It's a metallic solids with the condition of base to form iron hydroxide. Here the metal hydroxide. When metal is iron react with ammonium, it's a salt. The condition of base, it form iron hydroxide. It is a metal hydroxide to form ammonium as a salt product. The same time, copper as a metal react with ammonia to form a coordination compound. In the coordination compound, later we will discuss. Just note a compound of tetraamine copper 2 ion as a coordination compound. Is it clear? Then the formation of amines. Is it clear? The formation of amines. Ammonia form ammoniated compounds. What is ammoniated compound? These are example of ammoniated compound. NH3 ammoniated with calcium chloride. It's an ammoniated compound. Iron dipole plus minus is a dipole. What is dipole? Oppositely charged species. Interaction or attraction is a dipole. In this case, the negative end of ammonium dipole, ammonia dipole is attracted calcium 2 plus ion. It can also act as a ligand. Ligand is a electron donor to the central metal atom. Generally, what is ligand? Ligand donate a share pair of electron to the metal atom. There is a ligand. Okay, so it form a complex coordination compound of it is a cobalt metal compound. It is a silver metal compound. Okay, these are the coordinated compound. We will discuss about later. Okay. When excess ammonia is added to aqueous solution, it is noted excess ammonia in aqueous solution, it form excess ammonia in aqueous form a copper sulfate. Okay, is it clear? Copper sulfate in a deep blue color compound. Just underline copper sulfate, deep blue color. Okay, hydrated copper sulfate, the color of hydrated copper sulfate is a deep blue color. And next, the formation of amide and nitrates, where metals sodium magnesium reaction with ammonia to form sodium amide and magnesium nitrates. Okay, when sodium react with ammonia to form sodium amide as a product, when magnesium react with ammonia, it form magnesium nitrate as a product. This is a formation of amide and nitrates. The metals are react with ammonia, they form amide as well as nitrate compounds. Then reaction with metallic solids. These are the metallic solids. Okay, iron react with ammonium with the condition of base form metal hydroxide, then salt. Then copper ion react with ammonia to form tetraamine copper 2 ion as a coordination compound. okay, reaction with metallic solids to form a different type of products. The next, the formation of amines. Okay, the ammonia form ammoniated. Already we discussed. Okay, then the structure of ammonia. Okay, next we are going to discuss about the structure of ammonia. Just note out, nitrogen is atomic number 7, and then electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, then 2p3. Consider the valency electron is 5, 2s2, 2p3. Among these, bond pair electron is 3, lone pair electron is 2. Where is a bond pair electron? Nitrogen 1, 2, 3. 3 are responsible for bond pairing, and 2 is a lone pair electron. What is lone pair electron? The excess of non-bonding electron is considered as a lone pair electron. So other 3s are bonded with hydrogen. So bonded with hydrogen, nitrogen, hydrogen, nitrogen, then hydrogen, nitrogen. So 3 bond pair electron nitrogen, 1 lone pair electron, pair of electron, 2 electron. Okay. So here the distance hydrogen, nitrogen 1.1020 Armstrong is a distance between hydrogen and nitrogen, and the band angle between hydrogen 2, hydrogen 107 angle. So lone pair is also there, so it form a trigonal pyramidal structure. Just consider, is it clear? Is the atom of nitrogen, is the atom of hydrogen. Just note, ammonia molecule is a pyramidal in shape. Nitrogen to hydrogen bond distance 1.016 Armstrong, and hydrogen to hydrogen bond distance 1.645 Armstrong, and the bond angle between hydrogen to hydrogen 107 angle. The structure of ammonia is a tetrahedral, lone pair of electron in one tetragonal position. Hence, it is a pyramidal in shape. Okay, students. So thank you.